Hello friends, good morning. In last lecture we discussed the circulation of blood in human heart, the double circulation. Now today we have to discuss the next topic, that is blood pressure. Blood pressure, it is related with heart. Actually it is the subtopic, that is more to know, means it is only for our information, but we have to discuss. Blood pressure, what is called blood pressure? The force of the pressure that exerted by the blood on the wall of arteries or wall of blood vessels is known as blood pressure. When the blood coming out from the heart with pressure, this pressure always is exerted on the wall of arteries, because what is called artery, that we had already discussed, that the blood vessels which carries the blood from heart to different organ, and the blood which coming from heart having high pressure, so this pressure exerted on the wall, that is called blood pressure. These pressure are of two type, first systolic and second diastolic. So systolic and diastolic pressures are two different type that we have to discuss. What is called systolic pressure and what is called diastolic pressure? It is nothing but, it is the contraction and relaxation of ventricles. I repeat, what? It shows the contraction and relaxation of ventricles, that is systolic and diastolic. Now, what is called systolic? Systolic indicates the contraction of ventricle, means ventricular contraction, and the diastolic shows the ventricular relaxation. So, ventricular contraction and ventricular relaxation. Now, you know that when you visit some doctor's clinic and you see he or she measure the blood pressure of patients, how? He or she has an instrument called sphygmomanometer. So the blood pressure measured with the instrument known as sphygmomanometer. Sphygmomanometer. This sphygmomanometer has different parts. One, the column in which the mercury is present. Second, the cuff. And third, the balloon, which is present in the hand of doctor. So now, what happens? First, the cuff is tied here because the major artery passing through this part. So cuff when belt tied, and then the balloon when applied, it pressure here. That's why the flow of blood from this major artery, the main artery, stops. At this time, doctor wear the stethoscope. Now, what is called stethoscope? The another instrument that is used to measure the heartbeat. That this speaker, this stethoscope, doctor placed here. Then what happens? Then he or she slightly open the screw, so that what happened, the blood passing through this. At this time, when they hear the noise, they measure the pressure, then they memorize. And this first time noise which sound, this sound when here is known as ventricular contraction, and that is called systolic. And this pressure is 120 mm of Hg, means the mercury level in the sphygmomanometer. While again the screw, then when the opening, and then at one time another, the sound stops, and this point is known as ventricular relaxation, and it is 80 mm of Hg for healthy person. It is for healthy person. So our blood pressure range is always 120 by 80. This is for the healthy human being. Now it may be vary in different person. Sometimes some circumstances increase the pressure, that we called blood pressure high, that is also known as hypertension. And if hypertension takes place, what happens? In these, the contraction of arterioles, which are very thinner, the contraction of arterioles takes place, and this contraction leads into hyper blood pressure, hypertension, and sometimes the blood capillaries may be ruptured and internal bleeding takes place. So it is very harmful to human beings. So we have to maintain our blood pressure in this range, and it is for healthy heart. So that is the topic, blood pressure. Okay, now the next topic, which is given the blood vessels, but we already discussed it earlier, because I tell you that first, if we have to understand the structure of heart, then we need to understand the blood vessels. That's why we take this topic first. So today we have to discuss the next topic, that is the maintenance by platelets. Maintenance by platelets. Now platelets are also known as thrombocytes. These platelets are one type of blood cells. Now what do you think, what happens if the leakage takes place in our system? It means what happens when we injure, when the injury takes place, the blood capillary is cut from this part, and when the blood capillary is cut, the leakage takes place and the blood comes out from the body. Now if it doesn't prevent, then the blood pressure decreases, and it is not sufficient for our body to take the required substances to each and every part of the body. That's why we need to maintain the blood pressure, and we need to maintain the flow of blood from our body, and it is done by platelets, that is called thrombocytes. It regulate these blood clot, it regulate the blood clotting. How? The wall of platelets are very thin and very sensitive toward the atmosphere. It is for your information. So what happens when the blood comes out, the platelets come into contact with air. Due to high pressure, the cell wall of these platelets ruptures. When it ruptures, it secretes one specific type of chemical, and this chemical is responsible for the clotting of blood. So that's why the platelets are responsible for clotting of human blood. That way you will this study in 11th, 12th, and how the blood clots. Okay, here I want to mention that we had discussed the blood plasma in earlier lectures. This blood plasma contains specific type of protein that is called fibrinogen. This fibrinogen also help in clotting of blood. So blood platelets maintain our blood clotting, and that's why the more amount of blood cannot comes out from the body. So that is maintenance by platelets. Now the next topic, the next system that we discuss, that for transportation we need two. There are two systems, circulatory system, and then second one is lymphatic system. So now today we have to discuss the lymphatic system. Lymphatic system Now, we discuss the structure of arteries and vein. So first I want to draw it here again and we shall understand the topic. It is main artery that we called aorta. There are branches of these aorta are called arteries. Now arteries further divides and form the smaller branches that are arterioles. These are arterioles. And now these arterioles again divided into smaller branches between the intracellular spaces, and these branches are known as blood capillaries. So here these are the blood capillaries, and here there are cells. Now between these intracellular spaces, what happens? When the blood capillaries pass, this wall of blood capillaries possesses minute pores. So what happens? When blood coming from aorta, here blood. Now you know that blood means two things. One is plasma and second is blood cells. So all these material transporting through this path. Now what happens when the blood reach here? Some amount of blood plasma, some blood cells and protein escape from this liquid, from this blood, and they comes in between intracellular space, and this liquid is known as lymph. So lymph is another type of fluid, liquid or fluid or tissue, which is colorless. So see what happens here. Some amount of blood plasma, blood cells and proteins escape from the blood between intracellular spaces. These, what is these? It is the mixture of plasma, blood cells and the protein. Majorly this protein is not fibrinogen, okay? Less blood cells, mostly WBCs, means white blood cells, and some amount of plasma. This mixture is known as lymph. So what is called lymph? So we say that when the blood passing through the blood capillaries, from the wall of blood capillaries, from the pores of wall in the blood capillaries, some amount of blood plasma, blood cells and protein escape from blood in intracellular space. This is known as lymph. Now this lymph is also responsible for the exchange of materials to the cells, that we shall discuss. This lymphatic system is made up of lymphatic capillaries, lymph vessels, lymphatic nodes and lymphatic gland, that you will discuss in that you will study in 11-12 science, but I mentioned here. Now what is known lymphatic node and what is lymph vessel, that we shall discuss. Now what happens? These lymph give the material to the cells and take the waste material from the cell. Now this exchange takes place here from this intracellular space. Again this material must drain into the circulatory system, otherwise the material of blood decreases. So that what happened now from this part, the lymphatic system starts. This intracellular space contains the liquid, it is taken by the smaller capillaries like structure, they are known as lymphatic capillaries. So lymphatic capillaries take these intracellular fluid first, then these lymphatic capillaries opens into lymphatic vessels. I repeat, lymphatic vessels. These lymphatic vessels opens into the major veins. Major veins that we call vena cava. So again, it drains, this material drains into vein, and from vein it enters into heart, and again it comes from this part. So that is, the material escape from the blood, but again it mix with blood in vein. So that is lymph. Now what is the function of lymph or lymphatic system? So there are three functions of lymphatic system, mainly three functions. First, it drains the intracellular fluid. It drains the intracellular fluid with the medium of lymphatic capillaries and drains into the vein. So it is the first function of lymphatic system. Second, it absorbs the fat and digested material from the villi of intestine, and again it drains into the blood system. So it absorbs the fat in, I want to explain that these are the villi. The villi that are finger-like projections. So these villi also possess these lymphatic capillaries. So what happens? The fat and digested material also drains in these lymphatic capillaries, and these lymphatic capillaries drain this material into the blood system. And third, hence these possess blood cells, especially WBC. And we know that the WBCs are the soldiers of our body, means they protect our body. So third function of the lymphatic system is protect our body against the diseases. So these are the mainly three functions. First, it drains the intracellular fluid with the help of lymphatic capillaries into the blood. Second function, I repeat the second function, that it absorbs the digested fat from villi and drains into blood. And third function, it protects the body against the microorganisms or we call it disease. So these are the functions. So that is lymphatic system. Okay, so here we complete the lymphatic system. I repeat, lymph is a colorless liquid. Lymph is nothing but it is some part of blood which escape from the blood capillaries into intracellular space, and then it perform its function, and again it drains into the major vein. Okay, so here we complete the transportation of blood, or we call it circulation here. Now the next topic, that is transportation in plants. So here we complete this topic. So next topic, that is transportation in plants. transportation in plants. We know that there are mainly two things, that is water and food, that have to transport in plants from one part to another part. We already discussed that how the exchange of gases or carbon dioxide and oxygen takes place during photosynthesis and during respiration in earlier topics. Majorly, these plants possess two parts. It is leaf and it is root. Okay? We know that the plants get the water and minerals from soil, and water and carbon dioxide or whatever the gases from air. But the photosynthesis takes place, means preparation of food takes place in leaves. What happens? These roots absorb the water. This water is also needed by the leaves. So, if the distance between leaf and root is short, then the water which is absorbed by root diffuses to the leaves very easily. And also, the photosynthetic products that we called food also reach toward the roots by diffusion. Why? When the distance is very short between roots and leaves. But what happens in case if this distance is far more? If it is a higher plant and here one leaf is there, well, many leaves are there. So what happens? When the distance between the leaf and root is more or high, then the diffusion is not sufficient to take the water from soil to leaf and the food from leaf to roots. At this time, plants need proper transportation system. We also know that the requirement of energy of plants is less in comparison to human being, because they are steady. They cannot locomote, but we can locomote, that's why our need of energy is more. Second thing, many cells of these plants are very dead, so they don't need more energy for their life processes. But this transportation system is required to take the water or minerals from soil to leaf, or the food and other substances from leaf to the roots. For these, mainly two systems are present in the plant, that is called xylem and phloem. You already discussed or studied these xylem and phloem in standard 9. So here, this vascular system mainly for transportation of water and mineral, the xylem is present, and for transportation of food and other substances, the phloem is present. So the xylem and phloem are the main parts of vascular system, and that we know, these xylem and phloem combinedly known vascular bundles. So that we will discuss in next lecture, that how the water and the food transport from one part to another part. Okay, thank you.